So diffraction in grating. So grating has multiple slits of equal width. So here that it is made up of transparent material. So opaque rollings are made using a diamond pointer. So usually the conical grating has 6000 lines per centimeter. So here the rulings acts as obstacles of width B, and the transparent space between the rulings acts as a slit. So they are placing a ruling makes the lines. So it acts as obstacles of width B. So that is B. Then the transparent space between the rulings acts as a slit with E. So the grating elements. So the combination of that slit with obstacles, that is A plus B, that is a grating element. So the successive points in the grating is equal to that grating element E, that is the corresponding points in the grating. So the monochromatic light is incident on the grating. So it is diffracted. So the wavelength of light is comparable to the slit of, that is width of the slit. So that it is diffracted, that is bending of light waves. So the diffracted waves are get from at the point P using the convex lens. So a line is drawn at the center of that grating. So the diffracted wave makes an angle theta. So P is a point we are getting that bright, that is maximum. So here the path difference delta between the diffracted waves from one pair of points. So this is one pair of points. So the delta equal to A plus B sin theta. So A slid with that B, that is obstacles. So that path difference delta between the diffracted waves for one pair of points. So that is delta equal to A plus B sin theta. If it is whatever the pair of points, that delta is common. So delta is equal to M lambda. So here M is the order. Just combine, you will get A plus B sin theta equal to M lambda. So that is the order of the diffraction. So first zero order. So central is zeroth order, that is maximum bright. So we will discuss mainly the maximum. Zero order maximum, just substitute M is equal to 0, that A plus B sin theta, that is equal to 0. That is first order maximum, so just M is equal to 1. So A plus B sin theta 1 equal to 1 into lambda, so lambda. So theta 1 is a diffracted angle. So we will get that first order, this is a center, that is central bright, zeroth order. This is a first order, you will get. So it makes an angle theta. Here it's theta 1, first order maximum. And similarly for second order maximum, M is equal to 2. So A plus B sin theta 2, so 2 lambda. So if it is for higher orders, so either side of that grating, so you will get central bright. After that you will get again the bright, again here also bright. So alternate, you will get that higher order maximum. If you go on, you will get the maximums and bright and dark. So here N is equal to 1 by A plus B. So just rearrange, you will get A plus B equal to 1 by N. So N, what is N? That is the number of grating element or rulings drawn per unit width of the grating. So here I already told, so commercial grating have 6000 lines per centimeter. So here that N is the number of grating element or rulings, that is the lines drawn per unit width of the grating. So just substitute here A plus B equal to sin theta. So A plus B is equal to that 1 by N. So here this is 1 by N. So 1 by N equal to sin theta times M lambda. So just that M goes to here. So sin theta equal to M lambda. So NM lambda. So this is a diffraction for maximum for grating. So if it is for single slit, so here for first minimum, so that is A sin theta equal to M lambda. So here A sin theta is equal to N lambda. Here N is the order, here M is the order. So A sin theta, that is A is the width of the slit. So if it is for single slit, for diffraction for minimum, so So here sin theta equal to nm lambda, this is for maximum for grating. Just compare this, a sin theta equal to n lambda. So n is the order, here m is the order. So lambda as usual, that is wavelength of light used, that is comparable to the width of the slit, then only the diffraction pattern will appear. So here theta is a diffraction angle. So in this class we will discuss so diffraction in grating. So that ruling acts as obstacles, then the transference phase between the rulings acts as a slit, then the grating element E is equal to A plus B. Then we have seen that path difference between the diffracted waves. So diffracted waves, this is a diffracted waves. So you see the path difference, so this is a path difference delta, so delta equal to A plus B sin theta. So sin theta is equal to, so from here, so this is the successive points from here to there. So sin theta, this is the angle theta, so it makes an angle theta. So sin theta equal to opposite by hypotenuse, so this is opposite, this is delta. So sin theta equal to opposite by hypotenuse, so delta by, so this is the grating element E, that is A plus B, it is the corresponding points. So sin theta is equal to delta by A plus B. So delta is a path difference, so there is a path difference during the diffraction. So just rearrange, you will get the path difference, delta equal to A plus B into sin theta. So in general, so whatever the corresponding points, successive points, that path difference is same. So delta equal to M lambda, just compare with that, you will get general formula, A plus B sin theta equal to M lambda. If it is for 0th order maximum, so just it's 0. Then if it is 1st order, so M lambda, so it's 1. Then if it is 2nd order, if it is higher order, so higher order general form sin theta equal to n lambda.